Hey guys, welcome back to our channel. We're the Garcia Twins. I'm Britta.
And I'm Carly.
If you're new here, we would love it if you would subscribe down below. Today we're going to be swatching, lip swatching, and reviewing all 5 shades of the M Cosmetics lip cushion. So let's get started. Some stats from the website. So you can get these at mcosmetics.com. This is actually called the Lip Cushion Tinted Lip Luminizer. There are 5 shades, which you would have seen, right? Don't we? Do we do this?
Yeah, we do the swatches first.
Yeah. So you would have just seen all 5 shades, and it says universally. Oh, well, that's actually, sorry, that's describing the shade. Features and benefits. So it says adapts to enhance your natural beauty, adjusting beautifully to your lip tone. Formulated in Italy with hyaluronic acid for an enhanced hydrating experience. Infused with vitamin E, which is known to ease environmental aggressors. Cruelty-free and gluten-free. And it says twist base of the applicator to propel the formula. Apply directly to lips and reapply as needed. So not too many claims, obviously, since this is a lip product. So if we want to talk about the formula itself, I feel like lip cushion is the perfect name for this.
Yeah.
It feels like, to me, this feels like a lip mask in stick form. It almost reminds me a lot of the Laneige Sleepy
Mask.
Yeah,
me too. It feels like a lip mask, but not one that is like heavy or sticky. Like,
not sticky at all, no.
Like one that is kind of lightweight, but feels like an occlusive barrier still, which is really hard to find like a texture like that.
Yeah. I really think I don't have the Laneige currently, but the Laneige Lip Sleepy Mask, I feel like this feels similar to that.
Yeah, it does.
Obviously, this has pigment, and I will say I think this has more pigment than you would assume.
I
agree. Maybe when you think of a lip cushion or like such a hydrating, glossy finish, a lot of people would assume it's like more of a sheer lipstick. You know, like glossy sheer lipsticks are so popular right now. I think that this has, I wouldn't say that this is like a glossy lipstick, like it does feel like a lip mask, but it has pigment. So I just want to throw that out there because you will get pigment with this. So it is like a lip product. Like I don't think I would wear this if I wasn't wearing any makeup. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I agree. And so for the fill weight too, it's 0.05 ounces, made in Japan. So we were saying that.
Oh, I'm sorry, the price. Oh my gosh, sorry.
Oh yeah, yeah. This.
So just they are $22.
So I feel like that's a really good price for the amount of product. But we were saying that if you use this daily, it's kind of like a chapstick or like lip balm replacement, you would probably go through it pretty quickly.
But you wouldn't use it as a lip balm replacement.
Yeah, well, it is so nourishing though that I feel like some people would.
I guess.
But it should come out with a clear version.
Yeah,
that would be great.
But to Britta's point, it is so pigmented that, you know, we personally wouldn't do that. But I do think that, you know, there are people out there that would do that.
Okay, yeah.
Okay, and all the shades, what's your favorite shade?
I think the shade that I'm wearing, Venetian Rose, is my favorite because it's the most nude. And in any, like, range, I feel like I gravitate towards nudes. But especially in something like this, where it is, like, so glossy. Like, I don't know why, but whenever I wear, like, a pop of color, I always want it to be, like, a matte lipstick. I just never gravitate towards a glossy finish in a color. I always want a nude. So Venetian Rose would be my favorite, but if they could come out with, what's the liquid lipstick that we like?
Morning Mocha.
If they did a Morning Mocha, that would be my favorite.
I hope, like a brown tone.
I hope that's in the works, but I would say Venetian Rose is my favorite right now.
My favorite is Faded Clementine. I'm wearing that one right now. I usually agree with Britta. I really don't like, well, we don't like lip gloss, so you guys know.
Yeah.
But I don't like pigmented, glossy lips really ever. But Faded Clementine is just, like, I love the liquid lipstick version.
I love that, too.
And I love this color just as much. Like, it's just such a beautiful orange. So this one is my favorite. It's the newest one out of the bunch. But I like Venetian Rose a lot, too. And I can't stop staring at your lips. I feel like they look so, like, plump and hydrated.
Yeah, that's another thing I was going to say. I do love how, like, this will never accentuate your lip lines. Like, I will probably be wearing a formula of this nature when I'm like 70.
Yeah,
I feel like it'll just keep your lips looking so youthful, which is always what we're after.
Mm-hmm.
So I do really, really love the formula. The shade range, I do think that the shades are really unique. I just wish there was a more like my perfect nude, but that's just being selfish. There are only 5 shades, so mm-hmm. I hope that they expand obviously into more. And I do think it's nice that they are more unique offerings. Like this shade, what is this? Mystic. It's like that deeper berry. Really, really beautiful, and something that I would never think that they would do a color like this in this formula.
Yeah, I really love that one too. That's one of my favorites. The original is Magic Hour, and this is actually my least favorite.
Yeah, I don't love that. I love the component color though.
Yeah, me too. But they're all really unique, like Britta said, which is great. I think that we appreciate unique shades. We don't like shade ranges that have like the standard like pinks and maybe a red in there, and these are all really unique, which is great.
Yeah.
And another point on the formula, sorry, this video is all over the place. We haven't filmed in a while. I feel like we're a bit out of it. So reason we really don't like lip gloss is because it can migrate, and especially if it's tinted, like it will make you look disastrous, or like you eat one little thing and it'll just get everywhere. But this doesn't migrate at all.
No, it stays in your lip line.
It stays where you put it, which is perfect. And another thing that I really like about it, like earlier today I was wearing our favorite MAC strip down liner, and I just sort of dabbed Faded Clementine on top. And you can't add too much, I will say. Like if you apply it too much over a lip liner, it just kind of like overtakes the lip liner color anyways.
Yeah.
And kind of like moves that lip liner around, even if it's like a budge proof liner. So I wouldn't really like highly recommend using like a full-on coat of this, but I just sort of like dabbed it on top, and it added like the prettiest like sheen, like made my lips look a bit more juicy, but then just added like a little bit of color. And I really like that versatility too, that you can do that, but don't like swipe it on. I feel like you'll just end up with a bit of a mess if you do that.
Yeah. So we always rate the lip products that we do these review swatch videos on. So Carly, what rating would you give these lip cushions?
I would give them a 4.7.
Okay, I was gonna go with 4.5.
Okay, yeah. So I think the only downside, which this is totally personal, well, there's two, I guess, is I wish there was a little larger shade range. I also think maybe having some more sheer versions, like Britta said, for maybe like the older demographic.
Mm-hmm.
I think that these would be really great for, but I don't know if that demographic would really want like such a punch of color. So having some more sheer versions, like a brown, like we like. But I do think they'll expand the shade. And then number two, this is just personal preference. You guys know that we just don't love glossy lips.
Mm-hmm.
So it's just like on me, I don't love, like I keep looking at Britta's lips though, and they look so like nice. So it's like really nice, but it's not something I'm used to on myself. With like that more high shine look. I know that the reason that this looks so nice on the lips is because it like has a high shine appearance, but just because it's not my all-time favorite finish, that's like why I dock like a 0.1, 0.2.
Yeah, I think I'm in agreement with both of those points. My biggest thing is the shade range. Now that I said it out loud, like they have to come out with like a clear or like a slightly tinted, because I would literally wear that every day.
Yeah, me too.
Like I feel like a clear would be so nice to just throw on when your lips feel dry, but then it looks like juicy and nice. I would literally wear that every day. So that would be amazing. And then I just wish there was more nudes, because like I said, personal preference. I'm never gonna wear, not never, but like I would only wear this color. I love it, a beautiful berry, but I would only wear it if I have like a full face of makeup done like I do today. Whereas sometimes you wanna grab for a formula like this when you're not really wearing that much makeup, but like because the pigmentation is there, it looks a little off. So I think really just the shade range is
like
my biggest thing.
Some more sheer offerings mm-hmm. would make it more versatile.
But I love the formula.
Me too. And but could you imagine if there was a way to get this like effect on the lips but still like matte it out a bit?
That's not possible.
I know it's not possible.
Because then you'd have to have more powder.
I know it's not possible. Yeah. But matte lovers here.
What
if there was a way that could work?
I also love the component. But I love that they like each one is an own unique color.
Yeah, color matched.
It's very cute. They all look really cute together.
I know. We have to take a cute photo of them.
So anyway, we give these a high rating. We just want them to expand a little bit.
Yeah.
But we're really excited to see where this product goes.
Yeah, and so it's a nice size component too. Like it fits in your hand well, mm-hmm. or fits in our hands well. We have tiny hands, but I always appreciate that.
Yeah. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. We hope you enjoyed it. If you've tried this product, please let us know down below.